So here is a Stunticon. A Traitor. And a Renegade. Let's compare, shall we? What's going on, Transformers fans? What's going on, race car fans? I got a couple of race cars here in front of me. This is the Classics version of the Mirage mold. Here is Mirage. And repainted into Dragstrip, the Stunticon homage. And Fracture, it was a Walmart exclusive Revenge of the Fallen, which doesn't make any sense at all. Fracture, who is an homage to the Gobot Renegade Crasher, which is cool. She was cool, I should say. So, yeah, I do like me some female robot action. That's cool. And Crasher was one of my favorite Gobots. I used to watch the Gobots as well as Transformers. So, yeah, I've got a few. Unfortunately, I don't have an original Gobot Crasher. I always wanted her, and I could never find her. I found a white one of her at one point. I think it was repainted or something, and I didn't buy it because I wanted the black and red color scheme like we have here. But these are very nice. Very, very nice figures. This, in fact, you know what? I'll tell you what. Just, I'll take a whole IndyCar track or whatever these cars are supposed to be. Give me a whole slew of them. Just keep repainting this one. This one to me is like a seeker mold where I don't think you can go wrong. I think it's a great mold. I think they look gorgeous in both modes. So if you want to keep giving me more of these, I'll keep buying them. I like them. I think this is these guys are all winners, and I really do like them. So let's have a look at Mirage first. You can see his rub symbol starting to come to life under the extreme heat of my lights. If he goes up in flames, it is because I've got two painter's lights at about 500 watts apiece shining at this thing. So he may melt in my hands, or my hands might go up first. We'll see. Hopefully we'll keep this short enough to where we don't have either happen. But he's got, says FP Racing on here, WitWiki, spark plugs. Doesn't have the cigarette brands that he had on the original G1 toy. You can get Repro labels to put the original stuff on them. And I was thinking about maybe doing this. This doesn't really bother me that much, though. I think this looks pretty nice. You see an orange here. It's got something written, I don't know, Lithonian drivetrain, says. Something a little cutesy there. So that's kind of cool. But here's Mirage. Let's have a look at Dragstrip next. So here's Dragstrip, and I got a little bit of quality issue with my Dragstrip here. This one doesn't want to like peg in quite as nice as the Mirage and Fracture does, but it's okay. I'll take it anyway. Got a very nice color scheme. This is very reminiscent of the Generation 1 Stunticon. I personally don't own any of the G1 Stunticons. I hope to correct that this month, so that will be nice if I can get my hands on a Metasaur. So that's one of the things I am looking to do this month. It's one of my little personal goals. Maybe I'll wait for my tax return and get me a little Metasaur action. This is a Walmart exclusive Fracture. This was under the Revenge of the Fallen line. I don't have a clue why. This doesn't make any sense why it would be under that line. I did not get this at the time when the movie came out. This was actually something that I got from Ojunix, my buddy Ojunix. And I'll probably put his link, or at least a link in the comment column here, to his page on the TFW 2005 forum. He's selling a lot more cool things just like this. And he's got another Fracture if you're interested as well. This is the one I got from him. This is, an homage to the Crasher. And very, very nice. Very nice. So let me get all three transformed. And, I don't know, maybe I'll do a little montage. Okay, so we got them transformed, and they are a beautiful looking bunch. Wow, do I like these guys. I'm impressed by them in all sorts of ways. Let's start off with Mirage, since he is basically the original here. And they make a Ghost Mirage, and I'm not sure if it's a official or if it's a knockoff, but they do make a clear version of him. I don't own that. I'm not real interested in getting it, so I probably will not. I mean, if I find one that's really cheap, which I know is not, but if for some reason I find some fluke way of obtaining one and it's not a lot of money, I'll pick it up. But I don't know. I'm not really into that. I'm not into the ghost figures that much. So, but there's Mirage, and nice, man, just cool looking, very very poseable. In fact, this mold is one of the most poseable molds in the, gosh, in any Transformers line, I should say. I mean, he can really get into some very, very cool poses and hold the pose as well. At least Mirage can. The other two, not so much. Their QC is not as nice as Mirage's is. He is a little bit more stiffed jointed, if you will. So he can hold a pose nicely. Let's get him back here into the background. Pull out Dragstrip. Now my Dragstrip is very loose in the legs and in the feet. He has a problem standing. I'm kind of disappointed with that. But I got this guy for retail. I don't know how, but I did, and that was nice. I didn't pay much more than whatever, 12 14 bucks for him, and I was pretty shocked by that because I think he's gone way up, skyrocket price wise. So his arms are nice, legs are not. So but very cool. You know, they got the waist joint and the ball joints everywhere. I love his purple and like a teal looking face that just does not match the color scheme of the vehicle at all. It is just like his Stunticon counterpart. See his legs there wonking back. And yeah, I do dig me some Dragstrip. So, very, very cool looking dude. And let's get on with this. Now, I did not put her gun in. You can peg the gun into the back to store it there if you don't like it. Because everyone knows GoBots don't use guns. They just shoot out of their fists. So, if you remember the old cartoon, they basically make a fist and some laser beams come out of it. That didn't really hurt anybody else. So she's got a pink face, just like her GoBot did, and she's nice as well. And this could be pulled off as a female figure. I think, you know, it's got a nice slender build on it, so not too bad. I mean, not to take anything away from Mirage, sorry there, buddy, but yeah, you know, you got a girlish figure. What can I say? So this has been Mitch Santona. I'm going to wrap this video up saying I recommend all three of these. I love all three of these. I think they're all great. Do I have a favorite? Gosh, I guess I have to go Mirage. I really am more of a Decepticon than Autobot fan, and I do love that Dragstrip. And the Fracture is very cool, too. I mean, any homage to a GoBot is pretty sweet, so... Yeah, I like all three of them almost equally. I think if you're going to get one, economically, I think Mirage is probably the cheapest at this point. I'm not certain of that, though. But I do recommend this mold. Definitely grab one if you can find one. So this has been Mitch Santona. Guys, thank you for watching very much. Rate, comment, and subscribe. And we'll see you in a few.